Welcome back to the video. Let's talk about how much money I lost in the past 2 weeks of trading, because we all saw that tech had an absolute crazy crash from the very top at plus 12% for the NASDAQ all the way down to only plus 1.85%. From the top to the bottom, it was about a 12% drop. A 12% correction for the tech industry is absolutely huge. But then again, you had like an insane run-up, so maybe that is why we had a huge bubble pop. But of course, it was very painful, especially to me and also for a lot of you guys. Now, before it started, definitely check out the Discord server, link in the description below. Click on it, join the Discord. It's completely free. There's more than 12,000 members. We talk about options, stocks. It's one of the most active, one of the biggest option stock discords on the Discord platform. Best of all, it's free. There's also a Webull sign up link below. Click on it, make a Webull brokerage account, deposit $100 and get two free stocks. It's a phenomenal free money promotion. So let's talk about how much money have I lost in the past 2 weeks, because it's pretty painful. You can clearly see my account size has shrunk by thousands of dollars. It's really not a fun time to have, but I did already make back a few thousand dollars already by passively trading, and I mostly day trade cash secure puts. That is why I day trade, and it's honestly pretty good. I'm kind of used to Thinkorswim and also TD Ameritrade. They're extremely good brokerages. Let me give you guys a little background of what went on in the past couple weeks. Tech had one of the biggest drops that we have ever seen for a very long time. In fact, this was such a fast drop that a lot of people got caught with their pants down. QQQ, which tracks NASDAQ, was plus 12% in the past month. Everyone was making wild amounts of money. If you just dump any cash in any major tech company, you made money. And part of the blame for this huge, insane surge in the bubble pop was because Apple announced a stock split, which drove the price up. And then Tesla announced a stock split, which actually went up almost twice its original valuation before the stock split. And eventually the bubble popped. Cloud stocks, tech stocks alike, everyone just felt like it was going up way too much, especially when the small cap, mid cap, banks, vacation, hotel stocks have not even recovered to all-time highs. Whereas tech, well, it's already hitting an insane, frenetic level already. And so far, you got this giant plummet. You could clearly see it went from the top to the bottom. It was a negative 12% correction. That is a lot of money. We rebound a little bit, but now it's going to be an extremely slow crawl up, which I really don't care too much about. But of course, my account did get blown up a little bit, but of course, it wasn't too bad. I actually did cut my losses in some areas here and there. There were a few hours when there was a lot of dipping where I didn't go in. That was actually a very smart move. So if you check out TD Ameritrade so far, now, don't mind all this. I don't know why TD Ameritrade like adds in like this sort of a weird value when you deposit money. But of course, we will be focusing on this aspect. You clearly see on September 2nd, I was at an all-time high with my account at $41,710. It was really awesome. Had a lot of fun. I already made a few thousand dollars from just selling cash secure puts. Very nice, very passively. And then it started going down. Honestly though, after that day, I should have cut my losses after losing about $2,000 in a single trading day. But of course, I held on. I was really, really stupid, especially how the VIX was continuously to crawl up. And there was like a period of time where I didn't really trade too much. I tried to cut my losses, but I kept going in for some reason. I keep trying to catch the dip, especially for the tech industry. Remember September 2nd when it dropped, I automatically switched from tech. I closed my small cap Russell 2000 options and I went into tech. But guess what? Bam, it dropped again. It went up and it dropped even more. I kept moving my cash secure puts lower and lower so I won't get eaten alive. And it's honestly pretty crazy. And obviously at the very bottom, I was at $36,500. It was honestly pretty painful. Now I did make some money back, which is honestly pretty sweet. And currently my account is at $37,872. It's not too bad. I mean, I really want to hit about $40,000 again, maybe next week. That's most likely what's gonna happen. You can clearly see my current positions. If I win all of them, I will be having a cash balance of $40,399. That's honestly pretty sweet. If I check the stock futures right now, they're in my favor currently with the VIX at negative 2% and all the indexes super green. Now, this is actually very nice because tomorrow I will be making some tendies if it keeps up. And so far, I do have a lot of positions, 9 cash secure puts for TNA to be exact, cash secure puts, and a tomorrow is pretty green, maybe a 1 or 2% increase for TNA. I should be making about a few hundred dollars. Maybe at the end of this week, I may end up with probably $38,700, maybe even $39,000 if I'm lucky. I also have Workhorse. But of course, I mean, it's a pretty steep loss. I mean, from the top to now, I lost about $3,800. Pretty painful, honestly. But it's way better than losing like $5,000 at one point. I'd already made back about $1,200 by selling, you know, cash secure puts. It was honestly pretty good. At the low point, I was honestly super freaked out because I was down like $5,000, $6,000 total at one point during one of the sharpest declines of the NASDAQ around this area. It was 3 p.m., you know, September 8th. It was not a fun time. I mean, the markets dropped so much for TQQQ, I couldn't even open my brokerage account. I mean, imagine losing so much money that you mess up cooking eggs in the morning. That's what happened. Now, I also opened several cash secure puts for Workhorse, but I freaked out around September 3rd and I closed my trade, which is the stupidest thing I could have done because Workhorse eventually went up. I should have held on because I knew Workhorse was a very, very cheap stock and it wasn't like the big tech companies. This was like a small tech company. I pretty much consider it like a small cap company, and the small cap actually did pretty decent. It didn't drop that much during that crazy dip, honestly. And Workhorse could actually net me gains of an extra $1,000, but I closed it. Actually suffered a slight loss, but whatever. That's the past. But so far, I'm currently making my position back. It's honestly pretty nice to be seeing some nice green futures, and hopefully tomorrow it's pretty green so I can make back even more money. Now, the good thing is, even though I did lose a large chunk of money, it wasn't as bad as the people that straight up buy options. It's better than people that straight up bought shares for cloud and also the big tech, because those guys dropped a lot as well. I dropped about maybe 5 to 8%. And at the most one time, it was like 11%, but I've regained like a good amount of money back. So we all suffered losses unless you bought puts, of course. You made a lot of money. And so far, I gotta count myself pretty decently lucky. My account is still in a pretty decent shape. I mean, if my account got cut in half, I'm not sure what I would do. This is why I like cash secure puts. You make a lot of money when the market is flat. And you also don't lose that much money when the market starts tanking a lot. I was messing around with a triple leverage stock. It was up 42%. This thing dropped to a negative 1%. This from the top to the very bottom was like a 43% decrease. It was pretty insane. But with cash secured puts, you do have like the time decay on your side. So if you close it and you slowly move down, you will lose money, but you wouldn't lose that much. I will be making a more in-depth video of how to actually play cash secured puts if you're ever in a flash crash scenario, because you can still make a decent chunk of money. And honestly though, I did some pretty decent trades here and there. I paid a decent amount of commissions, but I'm pretty happy with what my account is. Even though I did get wrecked a little bit, it's still in pretty decent standing as well. So I'm honestly not too afraid. Losing $3,800 in the past 2 weeks of trading is extremely painful, but I'm ready to make that money back. And I wouldn't even mind if the market is extremely flat these few weeks. That's about it. Thanks for watching.